I've been involved in aerospace since the very beginning of my career. I've been involved in spaceflight since 1984. I learned very early on how hard this business is. I've lost friends, I've seen failures in systems, I've seen people being totally befuddled by something not going exactly right. And I've seen the emotional side of it when you actually lose people or lose a program that you've put your whole life into. I was at the Challenger accident. I was involved in the Columbia investigation. I was the mission director on the Orb 3 mission when we lost Antares. And obviously I've been following closely all of the recent difficulties we've had in getting hardware into space. It's a very difficult business. It will always be a difficult business as long as we're having to add energy at such a high rate, such a short period of time to get out of the gravity well. It's just difficult to do that and manage all the aspects of keeping that energy contained in a way that gets us into space. And when you've got humans relying on that technology, it means you've got to work even harder at keeping it safe. The key part of that, though, is if you have a failure, you can't let that stop you. If it ever stops you, then we lose something as a human race, in my opinion. The people who preceded us in exploring this globe, thousands of years ago even, never gave up. They just kept going and kept exploring. And I think that we have to keep doing that in space until we are able to find ways to make it less energetic, less risky, and can get people, more and more people, into space on a routine basis. But for now, it's going to remain hard until we have some big technological breakthrough. And if we have a failure, we've got to dust ourselves off and get back on the horse, whatever it takes, to keep going in that direction. The reality is, when we have a failure like that, you have some very smart and motivated people who deal with the emotion, they deal with the failure, and then they get right back to work in solving it. The beauty of working for Orbital ATK is that the day after the accident, our executive team already had the beginnings of a plan for return to flight. And I'm sure that's happened in every other situation that I can name when you've had a failure. People want to get back into space as soon as possible. If you give up on it, we give up on an entire generation of spaceflight, and we give up on all the things that the people ahead of us have done that we now stand on their shoulders for. And we can't let them down. We can't let the future generations down. If we have a failure, we've just got to figure out how to solve that problem, correct it, and move on.